This video will be focusing on something known as Metamask. Metamask is an extension for accessing the Ethereum enabled distributed applications. So it is a browser extension otherwise, and it is a software, basically a software cryptocurrency wallet, which is used to interact with the Ethereum blockchain. And it also accesses the Ethereum wallet through a browser extension. That's what we'll be installing in this video. And this can then be used for interacting with other decentralized applications. And in the next video, we'll be working and interacting with the Remix IDE, wherein we'll work on ERC20 and 721. So it also allows users to store and manage account keys, broadcast transactions, send and receive Ethereum-based cryptocurrencies and tokens. And it also ensures to securely connect to the decentralized applications, whatever we connect later, whatever we do with in the transactions ahead. So let's go to the browser and let's see how this installation part is done. So we have this Mozilla Firefox, and we'll go to the MetaMask search. We'll click the first search, we'll download it, and in Firefox, install MetaMask for Firefox, add to Firefox. A relatively very easy installation, no big deals. Okay, I'll allow it to run in the private windows. Okay, and herein I'm ready with the first run. So this is what we see on the first run. Welcome to MetaMask, get started. So there are two options in case you already have an account with MetaMask. So you can move in here and import your wallet here. Otherwise, in this particular case, in this video post, I'm just creating a wallet, and we'll get some faucet tokens just to show you how the transactions are done. So I agree. So I give out some password here. And yes, I have read the terms and conditions, and I agree, and I move in here. And now there is one option which I'll show you. Otherwise, this is not mandatory, but it is a recommended option so that you are always secured with your wallet transactions. So this is the secret recovery phrase. So whenever you install it for the first time, so it gives you a set of secret words. So let's see what it has here. So this is not supposed to be shared, but for the sake here in the video tutorial, I'm just making it tutorial. That's why I'm just sharing it with you all. So we have this secret set of words, and we'll just keep it safe, and we'll do next. Now, for the first time, or whenever you want to import your wallet, so this condition, this option is given whether you want to import the wallet. So these are the secret keys in the sequence that we have been given here. So they need to be clicked, and we'll just confirm this same. So we have got this cotton. Okay, I'll always on top cotton. Then we've got farm, rely, and then doctor, and then eyebrow, and then rally, and then cool, century, wet. What's the combination kind of is coming? Husband and mass, and then we move. We confirm. So now now this set of keywords, though I am not saving it here, but these are supposed to be secretly stored somewhere, encrypted, duly encrypted, because just in case you lose your wallet password, so then this is the only way that you can get back to your wallet keys. So since I will not be using this wallet, so I'm just not saving it, and I confirm it here. So all done, and we get the first interface. Now this is the interface that the users get for MetaMask, and these are the options that we get. So here, since we'll be using a kind of test network, so we'll give this option, show the test networks. Okay, it's not this one. Where is the test network? Okay, yeah, this one. So I am here, and I go back, and now when I see Ethereum, so I have this ropsten, coven, rinkb. So I can go to one of the options, ropsten test network. So now I have got zero Ethereums here. Now Ethereums, whatever are done on the, whatever transactions are done on the ropsten test network or any of these test networks, these are all faucets. These are all kind of fake ethers, just for developers and experimenters to experiment with. So you can get these faucets, ropsten, and you will get a whole lot of options wherein you'll be able to get some faucets, if not immediately. Sometimes they are immediately, otherwise it takes some time. So we the address is here, 0x9c, whatever, you click here and you just copy it and you just paste it here. Now once you paste it here, send me test ether. So this is supposed to send you some ethers, and your request has been added to the queue. So if you do it again, suppose I paste it again, so I'll be gray listed. You are gray listed. So for next 24 hours, I can only claim this faucets once. So maybe we'll try some other site to get, okay, this is error. Okay, let's see here in case I get something. Okay, request one ether. So now the address here is 0x9cc. We'll close this and we'll go here. So request one ether from this. So the moment I have clicked this button at this website, so this has automatically checked out that this MetaMask is already installed, and now this is trying to connect with my wallet so that it can just access my account address and it'll be able to send me something. So I say next and connect to the account, connect, and here it is connected. So it is not working right now. So this error thing we get. So these are few of the options that you can get free faucets from to test on. So we'll close this and we get back here. Now how do we get ethers here? So I have another browser wherein I have installed these MetaMask. So we'll just check that out, how many ethers are there. So we have some ethers here. So this is exactly the same interface that we have on a Chrome browser, and that here we have got on a Mozilla browser. So here we have got 8.9473 and we have got 0 ethers here. So we'll do some transactions here just to give you an idea of how the transactions are done. So we have this address, we'll copy it and we'll come to here, send. From this account I'm planning to send to some account. Now one thing to check is that here also I am on ropsten test network. So the faucets from ropsten test network, they will only be transferred to the ropsten test network because they have got a dedicated blockchain explorer to it that we'll see also. So now here send, and I'll give the address here, and I have 8.9473 and how many ethers I would like to send. So I'll just send one, okay, maybe 1.5 maybe. So I'll just send 1.5. Now when I send 1.5 ethers, it doesn't mean that I am exactly sending 1.5 and the other end also will receive 1.5. There'll be some gas expansion. There'll be some expansion on gas also. Now this is the estimated gas fee which is being levied here on this transaction. So this is a paltry amount. So we'll just confirm it. And from 8.943, the transaction is seen pending, and it'll take few seconds before there on the other browser that we are planning to send here, the same will be seen, 1.5. And let's see how much time does it take. So now you see these transactions have been confirmed. Transaction 6 has been confirmed. You can view it on the etherscan and we'll just see it. So 1.5 have been deducted here, and now these are all the details. So how much, what is the gas limit defined, these are default values, otherwise you can custom do the same thing. Now it has taken about 8-9 seconds, 10 seconds in this particular case of transaction. Now in case I would have given some extra gas, now the default value of gas, whatever the base fee that I have levied here, that I have put in here, now it is something 0.000, you can see it is something very low. Now in case I want my transaction to be indexed at a very good pace, immediately kind of a thing, in few seconds, 1, 2, 3 maybe seconds, so I'll have to increase the base fee in that particular case. So I'll have to expand more gas, that is more Ethereum I'll have to do, kind of a transaction fee that I'll be able to willing. So the total transaction which has taken on this browser, on this account from which I have transferred 1.5 ethers, it is 1.50000, you see 3.1513 account. Now what is the activity log? This is the activity log. Now if we want to see this on the blockchain explorer, so we'll just, this is the ropsten test network blockchain explorer, and here this transaction 0xd, now this is the transaction hash. So this is the transaction hash. It is showing the status is success block. In this block these transactions have been confirmed, and subsequent to this three blocks have already come up, and this is timestamp December 24, and this is the UTC time from this account and to this account 0x9a. So now we'll go to that browser, and I'm sure, yes, so 1.5 ethers have come here. Now in case we see the activity here, so again we click here and we'll be able to see the same transaction on the same explorer. So this was here, and this is here. So same, this is the transaction hash, and the same thing, because both the transaction has taken place, the transactions are indexed in the same block and they pertain to the same transaction hash. So exactly the same thing is being replicated here. So this is 11683573, and this is also 11683573. That's the block number, and rest of the things also will be pretty much the same. So all these transaction, whatever the gas has been levied here, expended here, what was the base value of the gas that we had seen in the wallet interface there. So absolutely same thing is available on at the click of a button. And now this information is immutable, all these transactions what we see. And this is what is the main characteristics of the blockchain. So graduating from this, now this is a simple MetaMask transaction, how the transaction is seen. So we can do one thing. Now, since my this wallet is absolutely, I'll be just negating it, deleting it later. So I'll just send it back. So I'll get the transaction here also. This is the account number of this 7.44. So now I'll try send and a transaction from here to this address. So a new address has been detected, and this is my balance. And now I would like to send 1.48 ethers. So next. Now again, this is come. So now you see estimated gas fee is 0.003315. This is likely to take about 30 seconds. So maximum fees is 0.0. So I can just increase it. So 0.0000315 is the maximum fees that can be that is currently on. So I will say a high fee I am willing to pay. So this says very likely in 15 seconds. So instead of 30 seconds, now it is taking 15 seconds through index. So I will might as well take this, apply this fees. So I do the confirmation here, and now it is likely it'll take much less time. So yeah, so it is being done. So let's see how much time it takes. So now this transaction has taken place in relatively less time in what we had taken. Now this account is left with 0.02, and now in that account I am back with 8.9273. And again, it is exactly in the same manner. We'll be able to see the transaction on the blockchain explorer. So this has taken place 1.48. I'll be able to see what has happened on the blockchain explorer. So this, these are again the details, transaction details, which are being shown. So that was the earlier one, that was a separate block, and now this is a separate block. So 11683591, and this is just one block confirmation, because this has just taken place 24 seconds back, and exactly the same details are available from which account the these things were transferred, the tokens were transferred. So this is what we have seen here. So in this simple small video, what we have done is we have checked out small features of what MetaMask is all about, and then we installed it on a Firefox browser. From this, after the installation part, there were some secret words that was about that you need to keep it secretly, so that in case I leave this machine and I'm willing to go out and do some transaction on some other machine with the same account, so I'll be able to use those secret keywords to import the complete wallet keys, the wallet the faucets that I'm holding. So they'll be immediately imported there, and I'll be able to do the transaction from the same account. So this 0x9c etc. And thereafter we logged into this MetaMask. This is the simple interface. We at the onset we had no ethers in the account. Therein we had access to another MetaMask, wherein we had about 8.9 ethers. From therein we did a transaction. We sent few faucets to the this Firefox browser, and therein we did another transaction from back. We transferred from Firefox to Chrome. So these two accounts were, these two transactions were had taken place, and these were immediately visible also on the Blockchain Explorer, which is the etherscan in this case. That's ropsten testnet transaction also. Now similar to this ropsten, you can do each and everything on Coven or Rinkeby or Goerili test network, and each of them have got different faucet sites. Each of them has got different Blockchain Explorer sites. So we'll just end up this video. So this was a brief introduction of MetaMask. In the next video, in the upcoming videos, we'll use these MetaMask, and in that thing we'll deploy and connect with Remix IDE and deploy smart contracts. We'll do some experiments with ERC20 and ERC721 to generate tokens, and again see all those tokens on the Blockchain Explorer and create our own coins. So thank you very much here, and do like and subscribe in case you have learned something here. Thank you very much.